The US Army recently unveiled a new variant of the Bradley fighting vehicle. The Army rolled out the M2A4E1 iteration, according to recent social media posts from the Service's Program Executive Office for Ground Combat Systems, POGCS. While there are several enhancements in the latest variant, the most important one is the integration of Israeli Iron Fist. POGCS's official Facebook page states, "The M2A4E1 is the most modern and survivable version of the Bradley as a result of integrating an Iron Fist active protection system. The new variant also has improved high-definition, forward-looking infrared gunner sight and an environmental control unit to prevent heat stress for dismounts." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Iron Fist would elevate the protection level of the latest Bradley fighting vehicle. Let's get into the details. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Platforms such as MBTs and APC have two protective choices, soft and hard kill options. Soft kill measures are of two types: onboard countermeasures, which are fixed to the platform, such as dazzlers, and expendable countermeasures, such as smoke grenades, which are ejected upon use. Soft kill measures may be used preemptively, but are more commonly employed in reaction to detected threats. The hard kill approach is kinetic in nature. In this, typically a small number of explosively formed projectiles destroy incoming threats before they hit the vehicle. Israel Defense Forces, or IDF, has been exposed to different challenges over the years and it's derived lessons from the experiences. For example, during the 2006 Lebanon War, a few Merkavas were destroyed using Russian-made Kornet ATGMS. IDF understood that it needed more than just strong army to fend off attacks on its tank and other vehicles. Iron Fist, or Porcupine Arrow, is a hard-kill active protection system, APS, designed by Israel Military Industries, IMI, with a modular design allowing adaptation to a range of platforms ranging from light utility vehicles to heavy armored fighting vehicles. The concept was revealed by IMI in 2006 and was expected to enter Israel Defense Forces tests by mid-2007. The system has been successfully tested against a wide variety of threats, including rocket-propelled grenades, anti-tank guided missiles, tank-fired high-explosive anti-tank heat ammunition, and kinetic energy penetrators. Israel has been at the forefront when it comes to active protection systems, with Rafael's trophy system being widely recognized for its commendable performance in real combat situations with the Israel Defense Forces. The Bradley Fighting Vehicle, BFV, is a tracked armored fighting vehicle of the United States developed by FMC Corporation and now manufactured by BAE Systems Land and Armaments, formerly United Defense. It's named for U.S. General Omar Bradley. It's one of the key assets of the U.S. military, and a significant number of these have been transferred to Ukraine. In June 2016, the U.S. Army chose to test the Iron Fist configuration to protect its light and medium armored vehicles as part of the Modular Active Protection System, MAPS, program. The decision to test Iron Fist was made mainly because the system's lightweight. In December 2018, the Army revealed it would be installing an Iron Fist on M2 Bradleys of 1 Armored Brigade as a near-term APS. An Armored Brigade consists of over 138 Bradleys. Difficulties for the vehicle to supply power to the system and intercept failures delayed integration. Dove Sella, the CEO of RADA, a subcontractor working for Elbit, told Jane's 360 in August 2019, "It's not a secret that the Iron Fist was allocated for the Bradley, and the whole process was delayed. At the end of last year, the U.S. Army decided to continue with Iron Fist and gave a time frame of about 9 to 10 months to sharpen the needles, tighten up all the loose ends, and come back to testing with a more mature system. The lingering issues were resolved. The new version of Iron Fist, designated Iron Fist Lite, had significant changes to how it was installed on the vehicle. It also features a new countermeasure solution that has a 70% successful intercept rate and has the ability to counter drones." Iron Fist senses incoming threats via a fixed active electronically scanned array radar sensor developed by RADA Electronics Industries and an optional passive infrared detector developed by Elbit's Elysera. When a threat is imminent, an explosive projectile interceptor is launched towards it. The interceptor explodes very near the threat, destroying or deflecting and destabilizing it by detonating its warhead. For this, only the blast effect of the explosive is used. The interceptor casing is made of combustible materials, so minimal fragmentation is formed in the explosion, helping minimize collateral damage. As per the Elbit system, it has a 360-degree coverage for site surveillance and situational awareness. Today's battlefield presents unique challenges to an infantry fighting vehicle or a main battle tank, and the future will be even more complex. The Ukraine-Russia conflict has shown that there's an ever-growing threat of anti-tank guided missiles, as well as advanced shoulder-fired infantry anti-tank weapons. Also, there's an extensive utilization of small drones for both recon and offensive operations. A key takeaway has been the use of relatively cheap commercial drones rigged to carry explosives. It's not hard to see that even the most well-protected platforms need an active protection system. The U.S. Army has been working to add active protection systems to all of its major armored vehicle platforms, such as the Bradley, the M1 Abrams tank, and the Stryker family of wheeled vehicles in recent years. The U.S. Army has already begun installing Trophy, which functions similarly to Iron Fist Lite, on its M1 Abrams tanks. It's likely that hundreds of Bradleys will have the Iron Fist in coming days.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.